let's review a case that can help you to understand the endometriosis very well. Look at here. A 34-year-old woman complained about dysmenorrhea. Dysmenorrhea, and infertility for 2 years. Look at the age. It is not 19, it is not 18, it is mid of the 30. What are the complaints here? Dysmenorrhea means pain during menopause and infertility for 2 years. This is not happened in the case of the primary dysmenorrhea. She had used a combination of olefactor pills from age 25 to 30. Here the main thing is the pelvic exam. As I also use the pelvic is the pelvic exam. Pelvic examination reveals a 5 cm prostate mass along with the utero sacral ligament nodularity. This is the main thing. When you call this thing, you must think about the endometriosis. Utero sacral ligament nodularity, secondary dysmenorrhea, endometriosis. So what is the pathology that endometrial gland stroma getting outside of the wall of the uterus? First, we suggest a retrograde menstruation. In the case of retrograde menstruation, when the menstrual flow coming down after the cervix, after the vagina, and flow out to the body, it goes backward, retrograde, through the fallopian tube, and spills out to the pelvis. And what organ right we get at the end of the fallopian tubes? The ovaries. Here. The first main site of endometriosis is the ovaries. Here, when the retrograde menstruation keeps falling down, it can also involve the pulse effect. The second most important common site of the endometriosis. In pulse effect, the retrograde menstruation can cause scarring of neutral sacral ligament that can cause neutral sacral ligament nodularity. This is a laparoscopic picture of pulse effect during menstruation. You can see clearly the blood in the pulse effect. But important thing here, some of the patients who have the retrograde menstruation don't develop endometriosis. So four main common sites of endometriosis. As you can see in the diagram, first is the ovary, then the cul-de-sac, then we have the uterine sacral ligament and the retrosigmoid. You can see here the four main common sites of endometriosis occur normally. Look at endometriosis in the ovary. You can see clearly the scar here. Here, this is endometriosis in the ovary. Here, you can see the uterosacral ligament nodularity. First, this is the uterus, this is the fallopian tube, this is the ovary, left ovary, right ovary. Here, you can feel the uterosacral ligament nodularity at both sides. Here. Okay, this is how do you check to feel the uterine sacral ligament nodularity here in cul-de-sac. You can do by pelvic exam, maybe you can insert the finger into the rectum and feel that area, the area of cul-de-sac.
Swelling here.
What are pain to find it? Pain with the intercourse and pain with the also the boy movement due to the endo leptosigmoid involvement here. That's
what.
Then the tenderness of and fixed retrograde uterus ligament nodularity. Third thing is normal WBC and ECR because there is no infection, no active infection. This one is a normal uterus. If it is not fixed, if it will not be mobile, then better you think this is endometriosis. At last, we talk about the management of endometriosis. So, as you know, the area of endometriosis, they could be exposed to a high prolonged level of progesterone in pregnancy. So, what would happen there? They would probably be shrink, probably atrophy happen there. So unfortunately, many of the patients of endometriosis, endometriosis are infertile. They can't get pregnancy. If we can't get pregnancy, for the pseudo pregnancy means false pregnancy. In this case, also the high level of progesterone, we could give the continuous medroxyprogesterone acetate. That also maintain, and we would do this for after 3 weeks. We maintain the high level because we have to maintain the high level of suppression. The second option, we could also give the oral suppressive pills. So these foods can give the opportunity for atrophy for shrinking of the area of endometriosis. So we have another option here. The pseudomenopause. How would we bring about pseudomenopause? By inhibiting the hypothalamic ovarian axis, and we do that by danocrine. Danocrine is anti-estrogen. Previous danocrine was used, but now we have plenty of estrogen that can lower the FSH level. Now we use leproglide. Gonadotropin releasing hormone. This is a common one. Okay, this is a very good one. Thank you.